हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू शॉर्ट हैंड सुपर फास्ट राइटर्स। दोस्तों, आप इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर लें और बेल आइकन को दबाएं डेली शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस के लिए। आज के मैटर की ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के लिए आप डिस्क्रिप्शन की लिंक पर जा सकते हैं और इस तरह की और भी डिक्टेशंस लिखने के लिए हमारे प्लेलिस्ट पर भी जा सकते हैं। शुरू करते हैं डिक्टेशन। ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 199 वॉल्यूम नंबर 10 से। बी रेडी। 10 seconds, 5 seconds, start। Mr. Deputy Chairman, the middle class is amongst the people hit hardest by the new taxation policy. On the one hand, the tax on their income is on the increase and thereby their income is decreased, and on the other hand, articles of consumption are being subjected to forces which raise their prices. In these circumstances, it will be very difficult for these classes to balance their budget, and the question of their saving anything and their investing their savings for purposes of common good is very problematic. Sir, the middle classes, as is well known, are the backbone of the society. They are the real workers of the land, and they should not be disabled or made vitally less enthusiastic by these measures in contributing towards the success of the plan. The indirect taxes have really got an inflationary tendency. To a complaint made in this respect, the Honorable Finance Minister said that the inflationary tendencies are already there and that the government, through these excise duties, will be able to mop up a portion of the extra profits for the benefit of the exchequer, and he implied that these excise duties need not raise the price in many cases. The inflationary tendencies are due to the play of market forces, and the prices will go up to a maximum that can be borne by the consumer. Sir, he seems to have a very tender heart for the inflationary tendency, but I do not know whether the inflationary tendency has got any compunction or consideration for the ability or the inability of the consumer to bear the prices that those tendencies may put up. In certain other cases, he admits that the excise duties do raise the prices, and in such cases, excise duties are designed to restrain consumption, either to bring about internal investment or to increase export in certain cases. I admit that higher prices may restrain and restrict consumption. For example, if the price of sugar is raised, people may consume less sugar. That is a known fact, but it must be taken into consideration. It is a matter of common knowledge that if sugar is beyond the reach of the people, they do not stop there. They take to the alternative articles. They go in for good or such other things, and therefore no savings is affected thereby. Sir, then take the private sector. increase targets have been set up in the 10th five-year plan for this sector, and they have to fulfill those targets in the vital interests of the country, because the development in the private sector forms a vital part of the economy of the country as a whole. But the question is, under the present proposals of taxation and the conditions that will be created by giving effect to those proposals, how is this sector to find its resources for realizing the increased targets that have been set for it? Everyone, the common man, the middle classes person and the upper class man, has to bear heavier burdens under the new taxation policy. The government want to mop up extra profits. They are increasing taxes on income, and they cut even into the corpus of the capital through such taxes as those on wealth and expenditure, thereby reducing the wealth already formed through the savings of the people. Under the circumstances, one wonders how the private sector is to find its resources for enabling it to realize the targets set before them. I do not know whether the finance minister he said anything explicit or clear on this matter. If the targets of the private sector are not fulfilled, that will create a grievous gap in the development of the country. What I think is, we must frame our plan mainly basing it on our internal resources and work that plan side by side with that. We may have another set of projects and schemes which may be executed as and when we get sufficient foreign exchange and foreign aid. Otherwise, what will happen is, if we are not clear-cut in this matter of keeping internal resources mainly separate from the foreign aid and foreign exchange, we will be landed in difficulties in the middle of the execution of the plan. Then it will be very difficult for the country to get back from the midstream. Then, if we set about to find foreign aid and exchange, the position of the country will have to be compromised in many directions, and that is not good for the country. Now, I want to deal with one or two concrete points which may bring in a sizable amount of foreign exchange to the country. One point is with regard to the export of raw goat skins. An export duty on the export of this article may be levied beneficially to the industry as well as to the country as a whole. There was an export duty of about 15% on this article. Sir, food problems has been the greatest worry of our life during the last 10 years, and unfortunately, efforts for its solution seem always to have gone away. In the present state of price index, the imposition of excise duties or their increase on essential commodities has an adverse effect on the common man. poor taxpayers talk of the income tax evasion to the extent of several hundred crores of rupees, and they say were strictly and honestly administered, there would have been no need of increasing the burdens of the people of low income groups and of raising excise duties on articles which are more the needs of the poor men than of the rich classes. The common man has, however, been found to be a passive victim of the taxation policy. So thanks for watching. Do like, subscribe and share.